In what could be a nation-changing experiment, Oxfam has formally offered employees a four-day working week. Under the landmark agreement, those currently working full-time can choose to have their hours reduced without any loss of pay.
To most of us, a four-day week sounds like a dream.
Why do I work for Oxfam?
Because I have the world's best boss.
But for Oxfam's 140 employees, that's just become a reality after a proposal put forward during enterprise bargaining to reduce their hours from 35 to 30 a week on the same pay was accepted by the not-for-profit.
This has absolutely come about because of our members at Oxfam and Oxfam's commitment as well to making sure that they're providing flexible working arrangements for their staff.
In Australia, a full-time working week is 38 hours, but most of us are doing much more. Advances in technology mean we're accessible at all hours of the day and night, prompting Greens leader Adam Bandt to introduce a bill in Parliament this week that'll give employees the right to switch off when you clock off.
You should have the right to ignore those calls and emails and texts from the boss after hours, unless you're getting paid for it.
Across the globe, the shift towards a four-day work week is gaining momentum. Belgium has already introduced a law allowing workers to choose whether they work a four- or five-day week. Last year, the world's largest trial of four-day work week took place in the UK. The result increased revenue and productivity, while a similar trial is underway here.
Oxfam will trial the shorter week for 6 months before deciding on whether to make it permanent. Kate Creedon, Nine News.